Are people with red hair and blue eyes going extinct? Now, when I was researching one of my previous videos on how red hair and blue eyes spread to Europe, I kept coming across articles that were asking this question about whether people with these traits were facing an extinction event. So in this video, I'm going to look at what this is all about, the main arguments involved and whether there is any truth to it. And if there is any truth to it, then I'm probably screwed. Now, let's first look at where this concern comes from. One main reason why people are asking this question is because of how rare it is to have both of these traits. As I noted in a previous video, having red hair and blue eyes is generally considered the rarest hair and eye colour combination on Earth, with it estimated that the percentage of people across the globe with both these traits is only 0.17%. As an interesting aside, other very rare hair and eye colour combinations are red hair and green eyes at less than 1% of the global population, and blonde hair and green eyes at less than 2% of the global population. Yet red hair and blue eyes is the rarest. The reason why this combination is so rare is because it's caused by two separate genetic mutations, both of which are considered recessive traits, meaning that you need to inherit the same recessive allele for both traits from both parents for this combination to appear. Redheads have a variant of the melanocortin 1 receptor gene, or MC1R, located on chromosome 16, which is involved in melanin production and is the primary driver of red hair. Blue eyes, on the other hand, are linked to a mutation in the HER2 gene, which influences the expression of the adjacent OCA2 gene, which again is involved in melanin production. So in order to have red hair and blue eyes, you need to have both these genetic mutations. Now, I should note that other genes also probably play a role in whether these traits are expressed or not, but these two separate genetic mutations are still some of the primary drivers of red hair and blue eyes developing. But are people with red hair and blue eyes actually going extinct? Well, one common argument for this basically says because this combination is exceedingly rare, this combination could be lost through a dilution effect, i.e. that the few individuals that carry these traits don't reproduce, so it's lost to future generations. Yet the reality is that many more people carry the genes for these traits, even though they are not necessarily expressed in that individual or even in their children. For example, it is estimated that around 40% of the Scottish population carry the red hair gene variant, but only between 6 and 13% of people in Scotland actually have red hair expressed as a trait. This means that the genetic mutation is carried by many more people than you may think. This reality can often lead to surprises. The fact that people often carry the genetic variation for these traits without it being expressed in them is why red-haired or blue-eyed children can seemingly appear out of nowhere. Even if two parents do not have red hair or blue eyes themselves, they can have a child with these traits if both carry the necessary genes. So as we have seen, recessive traits aren't lost easily. The only way people with red hair and blue eyes would actually go extinct is if carriers of these traits, either expressed or dormant, completely stop having children altogether, and this isn't going to happen anytime soon. Yet the story doesn't end here. Another argument that done the rounds in 2014, that you may have actually seen at the time, claimed that people with red hair could go extinct because of changes in the climate. But before we look at that, I would like to quickly thank my Patreon members for voting for this video topic. If you would like to vote for what video topics I make videos on, and also help support this content that is 100% independent, I will put a link to my Patreon page below. Also, if you like this jumper, I will also put a link to my merch store below as well. Thank you for your support, and now on with the video. Now, the proponents of this climate argument claim that the genetic mutation that is the main cause of red hair could have developed in Scotland because of cloudy weather. And if the climate gets much warmer and less cloudy, red hair could become less common. This argument has largely been debunked, however, and some argue it was as much a way to generate headlines and sell ancestry tests than anything else. It makes little sense to me as well. For one, I live in Scotland and I can assure you it's still very cloudy a lot of the time, and the rest of the time it's pretty much raining. This is a shot out of my window as I write this video script, and this sort of grey, overcast weather is the norm rather than the exception in Scotland. Anyone who lives here or has visited here will know how not so sunny Scotland is most of the time. Furthermore, even if climate plays some role in traits like red hair evolving, which I think is certainly possible in some way, any association between red hair and climate is indirect at best. You don't produce vitamin D from sunlight through your hair, it's through your skin, with lighter skin more efficient at making vitamin D from sunlight. So although people with naturally red hair tend to have pale skin as well, any connection is indirect between red hair and climate. In addition, there are probably other factors involved in red hair developing in places like Scotland in higher concentrations than other parts of the world that have nothing to do with climate. These include genetic drift and sexual attractiveness, for example. So despite all the scary headlines, people with red hair and blue eyes aren't going extinct anytime soon. And in fact, some people actually make the opposite argument, that people with red hair and blue eyes could become more common as opposed to less common in the future. This is largely based on how globally connected our modern world is, due to technology and the global economy, etc. This means that the mixing of different populations could lead to the genes for red hair and blue eyes spreading to areas where they were previously uncommon. I was recently in Dubai, for instance, visiting a friend, and that's a place that exemplifies this global mixing of peoples, a melting pot of people from across the world. Regardless of this, countries with higher concentrations of people with this combination of traits, i.e. in places like Scotland and Ireland, have strong genetic pools that support the continued presence of these traits, a home base if you will. So despite the fact that headlines about people with red hair and blue eyes going extinct may get the clicks, there is no real truth to it in my opinion, although these traits will probably remain rare. But what do you think? Please let me know in the comments below. And when you're there, please let me know what your hair colour and eye colour is, and if you know anything about your ancestry in general. I always enjoy reading your comments and hearing your feedback and family connections. Speaking of red hair and blue eyes, how did these traits spread to Europe in the first place? As despite what some of you may think, the origin of red hair probably wasn't in Europe, even though it's associated with places like Scotland and Ireland today. To find out, please click here. Thanks for watching. Like I said earlier, if you would like to vote for what video topics I make videos on, I'll put a link to my Patreon page below. Thank you for everyone for their support in general. Please get your comments in the comments below as well, and I'll see you next time.